We are on the fourth utterance of Jesus Christ on the cross, based on Matthew chapter 27, verse 46, and Mark 15, verse 34, where the word of God says, "My God and my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani." Before this hour, Jesus had been forsaken by the religious leaders among his own people. He had been forsaken by his own family, and at last he had been forsaken by his friends. It was in this feeling of being forsaken that the horror of the cross reached its climax. These words point to the fact that when Jesus died on the cross, all our sins, without exception, were transferred to him, and he was without sin, for he was God in human flesh. But all our sins were placed on him. He became the final and complete sacrifice for our sins. And in that moment, he was banished from the presence of God, for sin cannot exist in God's presence. His cries at this time speaks of this truth. He enjoyed the separation from God that you and I deserved. This is a profound truth, and yet should bring comfort to all of us. Because Christ died for us, we need not fear death or hell or judgment. The Bible says, "For Christ died for our sins once and for all." The sins create a barrier between us and God, but that barrier was demolished at this hour. And Paul reminds us that there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life sets us free from the law of sin and death. We find that passage in the letter of Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verse 1. And talking about the past tense, we have been crucified with Christ, and we no longer live, but Christ lives in us. And since we are justified through faith, we have peace with our God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into his grace in which we now stand. So the grace of God is sufficient for you and also sufficient for me, even during this time. So we must not despair, we must not be discouraged. Let's hold on to the truth which we find in his word. In the name of God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.